Team Jackson, what's happening? So, I got a question the other day from a young lady who said, you know, how do I go about protecting myself? Like, what is the number one thing I can do without becoming bitter and overly guarded? Because that's what I see a lot of girls do, and I don't want to be that. But I'm also tired of being hurt. And to even answer her question, first, I had to start with why a lot of women get hurt. And that's a loaded question, too, because, hell, some women out here are the ones doing the hurting, if we're going to be all the way real about it. But in terms of a good woman, right? The number one reason I believe a lot of good women get hurt, contrary to the belief that y'all just believe in a man's potential, I believe is because you guys see, or at least you want more for people than what they even want for themselves. That's in friendships and in relationships, specifically women with vision. Like those women who pour into people sometimes to a fault, I don't think for a majority of the times it's because they're just so desperate to believe in the illusion and the facade of a good man. I think it's a lot of times because y'all haven't learned how to properly manage the fact that you have vision. Like, of course, in general, a good woman automatically sees the best in people involuntarily. But specifically women with vision, y'all see the manifest in people. The problem is if you're not careful, you may apply yourself prematurely to try to manifest that in a person, to try to facilitate that before they've earned that privilege, which of course cost you. And by cost you, I mean hurt you. So what does it mean to properly manage your vision? It means understanding that yes, as a woman, you became who you are, you achieved this level of who you are on a personal level because of the work that you put in, because of the sacrifice and all the ethical things that you did to attain that. But you have to understand, not everybody else is built like that. Hell, a lot of dudes, if we're talking relationships, they don't want what's best for them. They want what's easiest to them. And if we really being real, a lot of women these days are easy as hell, physically and emotionally. So in turn, there are a lot of guys who don't value what's real. Like, they'll choose less growth over more effort, which is what a woman with vision is going to require at some point. That's exactly what Michelle Obama was just talking about recently, as a matter of fact. So that means those of you who have vision, you have to get to a point where you learn not to want more for somebody than what they want for themselves. You want only what they have the capacity to value by themselves. So yes, you can be this, that, and the other for a person. You can bring this, that, and the other to the table. But the real question you need to be asking is not necessarily what you bring to the table, because you already know that. But whether or not that man already places enough importance on those things and you to be motivated to step up to the plate and also be what's best for you. Because of course, you and everything that you bring is going to be best for him. If not, you're going to continue repeating that cycle of bringing the man the sun, stars, and the moon while he takes it for granted because he can't see any higher than the ceiling of his mama's basement. And I'm speaking figuratively and literally. So, y'all let me know what you think in the comments. I'll let y'all later. Peace.